In this GIMP workshop, we are going to apply the HDR or High Dynamic Range effect. If you want to follow along, the download link for the image is in the video description. When we've opened our image, we press Ctrl+Shift+D twice to make two duplicates of this layer. Double-click on the name of the bottom layer and change it to Original. Then hit Enter. Now press the upwards pointing arrow on your keyboard to select the middle layer. Press Enter and change the name to Overlay. Hit Enter again. Press on the upwards pointing arrow again, hit Enter, and change the name of this layer to Desaturate. Hit Enter again. When we hover with the mouse without clicking over the mode and unroll the mouse wheel, we can see the different modes and their effects. We make the mode of this layer Overlay. Press Alt+C to open the Colors drop-down menu, and then press the D key to make the Desaturation dialog box visible. Now we just press Enter. Press Alt+C again, and now the V key. Press Enter to invert the layer. Now we press Alt+R, then we press the B key, and then the G key to make the Gaussian blur dialog box visible. Drag the dialog box to the top of your screen and pull it out. Move the image so you can see the tram in the center. Make the blur radius 50 and click OK. Then we click and drag the middle layer to the top of the layer stack. We make its mode also Overlay. Press and hold the Shift key and click on the eye of the bottom layer. In that way we can see the difference. This is basically how we can make an HDR effect, and we could leave it like this, but we can however go a bit further. Make sure the desaturate layer is selected and press Ctrl+Shift+D to make a duplicate of this layer. Press and hold the Shift key and then click on the eye of the original bottom layer to see the difference. Another possibility is selecting the top layer. Press Ctrl+Shift+D again to make a duplicate of this layer. Then we can change the opacity to our likings. Here too, we can press and hold the Shift key and then click on the eye of the original bottom layer to see the difference. When you think it's too much, you can of course just delete these last added layers again by selecting them one by one and clicking on the waste bin. Just see what feels good for you. Anyway, here it is, our very own HDR image. I hope this helps, and if that's the case, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and a friendly comment to support my channel is much appreciated. Thank you very much for watching.